Next we are going to study ablaut or vowel gradation. The vowels played an important part in grammar of Proto-Indo-European because of the way how it altered in related forms like sing, sang, sung, etc. And this system descended to Proto-Germanic. So there were several series of vowels which were altered in this way, and each of the series, each member of such series were referred to as grade. Such a series of vowel variation in relation to the change of meaning were known as ablaut series by Grimm and are known in English as vowel gradation. Once a series in Proto-Indo-European, example of which is short E, short O and zero. This series was used in some of the strong verbs. The E grade appeared in the present tense and O appeared in past singular and zero grade appeared in past plural and past participle. Thus we have sing, sang, sung. Let us see that in detail. In original Proto-Indo-European, the words used for sing were sengv, which was E grade, songv, which was O grade, and sengv, which was zero grade. This gave rise to sengv, gave rise to singan, meaning to sing. Song gave rise to sang, meaning he sang. And sung gave rise to ge sungen, meaning sung. So sing, sang, sung. E grade, O grade, zero grade. When the change is in the quality of the vowel, it is referred like long or short, it is referred to as quantitative ablaut. And when one vowel changes into another, it is referred to as qualitative ablaut. So therefore, the six classes of Old English strong verbs shows six series of ablaut. Let us see that. Let us see the changes. First one, to ride. It was actually ridden. It changed into rad, which changed into ridon, and which changed to ridden. These are the ablaut series. Now next, meaning to choose. The word was siosan, sias, curon, koren. Next, to sing. It was singan, sang, sangon, sangen. To bear, beran, bear, baron, boren. Now next is to eat, etan, at, aton, etten. Now next is to stand. The word was standen, stored, stodon, standen. In modern English, we find a number of words which form a past participle by the addition of ed. Earlier, help. It was originally H-E-A-L-P, but in modern English it is H-E-L-P-E-D. Melt, originally it was M-O-L-T-E-N, and modern it is melted. The same way, the vowel change of gradation determined by whether it occurs in stress syllable or unstress syllable gives an emphasis in the meaning. Like in the question, like in this sentence, can he do it? So if the stress is on can, it will be can he do it? Then next, if the stress is on he, it will be can he do it? The stress is on do, it will be can he do it? So just depending on this shift in the stress, there is vowel change. Ablaut helps the growth of vocabulary by creating new words by the change in the vowel. With the changes in the vowel, it creates new words. So I hope you understood ablaut. Thank you.